When I bought my Pinto, I figured it was a good value. But I didn't know how good until my dad started borrowing it.
So I ended up buying my own.
Then I bought one. And I bought one.
And I bought one.
And we bought two!
Join the Pinto family.
This is the famous Pinto emblem that appeared in magazines and newspapers. This is the famous Pinto shape. But what made the Pinto truly infamous was the rear end. And that's where the fuel tank is located. And as you see, it is very close to the rear bumper, and in a rear impact, it gets crushed against the rear axle. The tank gets punctured, ruptured, fuel gets ignited, and there are infernos that have burned up people over the years.
Dussintals människor brännskadades i bilolyckor med Pinton. Mest känd blev Richard Grimshaw, som drog Ford inför rätta i Kalifornien.
Richard Grimshaw was a young boy, and he was a passenger in a Pinto that was rear-impacted, ironically enough, by another Ford. The car burst into flames, and Richard Grimshaw had his face melted, his body melted, his hands and fingers melted. It was a tragedy beyond belief.
För att skaffa bevis till rättegången började Byron Block undersöka utbrända Pinto-bilar. Men det mest graverande för Ford var att Block lyckades hitta ett dokument där Ford förklarade varför man struntade i att göra något åt problemet med bensintanken. I dokumentet står det att man beräknade att 180 människor skulle bli ihjälbrända och att ytterligare 180 skulle få svåra brännskador. Det skulle kosta företaget omkring 50 miljoner dollar i skadestånd. Att bygga om bilarna skulle kosta 11 dollar per bil, totalt 137 miljoner dollar.
Therefore, Ford argued, it was cheaper to let them burn. And it was that corporate attitude that convinced the jury to award 125 million in punitive damages as punishment to Ford Motor Company for that attitude of trading off human lives for a few dollars of profit.